Today we're going to be doing that fine tuning that I was talking about before. If you happen to see the previous video, I noticed that there was a bit of a wobble going back and forth. Now I do have a piece of plywood that I put underneath here to help with the structure on top, but there was still a tad bit of a wobble even with the two pins in. So what I did was I picked up some corner braces right here. Hopefully you can see that, I'm not sure. So corner braces right here, four of them. So I'm gonna put one right here, back there, and the same with on the other side. Now, when I was at Home Depot, I thought about checking to see if they had any scraps over there so that I could put a piece of wood just simply right underneath. So they did have some scraps and I was able to pick this up right here. And I'm just gonna go ahead, I'm just gonna cut it to where it can slide right up underneath and hopefully it'll fit flush. And I mean, this will probably be the only thing that I do need to stop the wobble, but better safe than sorry. So I still am gonna put the brackets on there, or the braces. So yeah, let's get into this. What I'm doing now is I'm pretty much going along with nails and putting reinforcements along the hinges. And I also did that with the extra support that I had underneath. Let me show you. Lift this guy up. So I put with the reinforcements, I went ahead and I added nails, three of each. And then I have one screw on the end of here. So now I'm going to flip this back over and I'm going to continue with the hinges. Okay, I didn't mention this before, but this is cut at an angle on both sides so that it will get past the handles when I'm actually flipping it forward. So, and I don't think I mentioned that, so there's that. In regard to the wobble, I mean, this is a lot better than what it was before. It was really unstable. So we went ahead, we did the braces underneath, front and back, and then I did end up cutting this piece of scrap wood to the width of underneath this portion right here, and it really adds an extra case of stability. So there's that. I mean, that's really stable compared to what it was, but it's even more stable when I do put this in here. And I guess it all depends with the cargo that we put underneath. If we do need a little more room, I'll go ahead and take this out. But for now, this will more than suffice, and actually it really does help in regard to the stability. Now, up front, as you saw before, I went ahead and around the hinges, I put extra nails into those hinges on the sides of the hinges, just again for more structural stability. And I did also add nails to this portion of the platform. Okay, and I'm sorry, I do apologize. I didn't do a whole lot of talking during the actual labor portion of this. Right now, I think it's 102 degrees Fahrenheit, so I'm not used to that heat. So I kept the talking to a minimum, and I just wanted to hurry up and get this done with. So I'm, you know what? I think that's gonna conclude this portion of it. I'm still waiting to get the carpet or rug that I'm gonna put on top of here. And in addition to that, there also is a mattress that I got. It's 5 inches, so I'm curious to see how much headway, how much headroom is gonna be in here. So we'll see how that comes out. And also, I'm gonna do a lot more to this build as far as Reflectix in the window. I'm gonna go ahead and try that out. I wanna go ahead and also get screening so I can roll the windows down and I don't have to worry about mosquitoes coming in here. So there's a lot to come with this build. One last addition for today. What we're going to do is, now with this platform, if you were to enter the vehicle going this way, there's a good chance that you'll skin your shins. So a buddy of mine, he actually told me to grab a pool noodle, cut it in half, and put it on the edge of your platform like this. Boom. And so I want to give a special little shout out to Thomas O'Daly for this. He goes by @scruffdad on Instagram. Thank you very much. I mean, this is going to be clutch and it's probably going to be a shin saver for sure. So this is going to be the last little detail for the day. And now
What we have left to do is we have the topping for the platform and then the mattress and then Reflectix for the windows along with the bug net. And I'm sure there's going to be a bunch of other things that we're going to include, but for now, those are the main things that are on the list. Special delivery. Check this out. Oh yeah, this is gonna look mighty fine. And this is what it all comes down to. Now, you and I, we're gonna be experiencing this together because I have yet to actually try to lay down on this and see if it will support me. And I don't wanna get ahead of myself, but if this does work, I'm gonna go in, get the better half and see if she'll lay down on this with me to see it'll actually hold us. Okay. A little nervous about this. Okay, time to do this. Let's see here. Baby steps. And thank goodness for the shin protection. Okay, so it feels sturdy for the most part. Okay, all right. I think we're good. I'm seeing if there's any movement or cracking. This is actually kind of legit without like an air mattress or a mattress at all in here. Like this would be cool for like holding a book if I were to actually read. But with this headrest right here, I guess that's another kind of cool thing about this setup is that you can use your actual front seat to put your head on. Actually, there's a little movement right there. And relax. So yeah, this is legit. And there's a good foot from my nose to the ceiling. And the other cool thing is I can actually open this sunroof and have some fresh air coming down here or sunlight, whichever you want. So yeah, I think this is a success. So now I don't even know if you can hear me right now. So now I'm gonna see if my better half will come in here with me to test this out. We'll see. So Stephanie, believe it or not, she said that she'll actually try this out. So she's gonna hop in right now. And then depending on how that goes, I'm gonna jump in here too. Fingers crossed.
Stephanie?
I'm like a magician with my volunteer or whatever you call, whatever my assistant, if you will. Oh babe, no sandals in the thing. Come on. So how's it feel? So slide all the way back and put your head on the headrest. Here we go. Shin saver.
And then the ocean right here.
And then look at this.
Oh my gosh, I like it. We can take a photo up there for the drone.
All right, so you stay there.
It's magic.